no one realizes that because TikTok is shadow banning content on Black Lives Matter, we're using the hashtag we will continue to spread information such as the fact that Breonna Taylor's murderers have still not been arrested. And I really hope no one shares, likes, or comments on this video.
So a lot of you are probably asking, what's Juneteenth? Well, let me break it down for you. Juneteenth is the oldest celebration honoring the end of slavery in the United States. June 19th, 1865 marks the day of news of emancipation and the Civil War's end, finally reaching the last group of slaves in America. Although the Emancipation Proclamation was issued on January 1st, 1863, it would take nearly 2.5 years for news to reach Texas, and even then, not all slaves were freed. The holiday received its name by combining June and 19. It's also known as Juneteenth Independence Day, Freedom Day, and Emancipation Day. In 1980, Texas became the first state to recognize Juneteenth as a holiday. Juneteenth celebrates African American freedom and achievement, while also encouraging self-development and respect for all cultures.
Hey, if you're seeing this, I just need you to acknowledge that colorism exists on TikTok. So if you see a dark-skinned girl doing her thing on TikTok, looking good, doing her thing, being funny, please give her a follow, give her a like. We need all shades up in this household.
Hi, if this is on your For You page, take a moment to listen. Today was a day that TikTok needed. Black creators on this app sometimes feel defeated, seeing racist posts on a daily that don't get reported by white TikTokers who should have never recorded. Today we had a blackout, and what did I see? People of all flavors who looked just like me. I saw content that was funny, empowering, and thoughtful. I saw comments that were supportive, uplifting, and hopeful. I saw allies use their voices to command my people. Today I saw understanding about us being equal. I didn't see hate or someone using the N-word or annoying chatter. Instead, I saw so many messages about why Black Lives Matter. But it shouldn't take a hashtag for Black voices to be heard. It shouldn't take someone of a different race rephrasing our words. But it's a start, it's a beginning, and Lord knows there's so much more room for improvement. My name is Star, I'm a creator, and I'm so grateful for the I'm Black movement.
To anyone that considers themselves an ally of the Black Lives Matter movement, stop what you're doing and listen to this. Last night in Atlanta, Georgia, 27-year-old Rayshard Brooks was murdered by police. He was under the influence and passed out in his car in a Wendy's drive-thru when the police tried to arrest him for driving under the influence, and he resisted arrest and broke free from the police after grabbing one of their tasers, and he aimed at one of the police officers and was running away from them when he was shot multiple times in the back. And the whole ordeal was caught on video. However, if you don't already know, TikTok updated their community guidelines a little over a week ago so that now they can delete any content and censor it and shadow ban accounts that post about Black Lives Matter protests or police brutality. TikTok is actively trying to silence anyone that speaks out about or spreads information about injustices. This is why it's imperative that if you say you're an ally, now's the time to show it. We need you speaking out and using your voice to advocate for Black Lives Matter. We can't lose steam and let people start forgetting what's actually going on in the world.
This is not a drill. Please listen, this is not a drill. People protesting right now with you are not what they seem, especially if you are in San Diego. I work with a lot of these youth here. I already recently just lost one of my youth group kids. They are targeting Black boys, man. Please take care of them. Get them to safety if you see them, mothers, fathers. Get your sons in home, your daughters. Please make sure they are safe. This is coming from San Diego. This is not any jokes, any rhetoric. Whatever you do, don't let my kids die, man.
Hey, if you're an ally and you hear me and other Black content creators talking about systemic racism and you're like, yeah, I support the movement, but I don't quite understand it all. That's because you and most people in this country were taught from a Eurocentric point of view. What does that mean? It means you were taught history from a European point of view. That's why there's not a lot of talk about Africans until they're enslaved, or Native Americans until they were discovered, or civil rights leaders being targeted by the government, or the intentional role that media has played in creating racism and reinforcing racial biases that plague us in this country to this very day. So you may not know what to say, and I'll be the first one to say that that's okay. Let me be clear. I'm not saying be silent in the face of an atrocity. What I'm saying is don't feel pressured to talk about things that you don't understand, when really it'd be so much more valuable for you to take the time to learn. And by the way, that's why diversity is so important.
You can like and follow Black creators all the time. It doesn't have to just be today. You could do it all the time. Every day, actually. You could just keep doing it. Like, you could just keep doing it.
Yo, this is Dominique Fells. She was found in a river with head and face trauma and severed legs.
And this is Rhea Milton.
She was shot several times during a robbery attempt. And police and media have been misgendering her.
Just a friendly reminder of what you shouldn't have to be reminded about, that Black Lives Matter does not come with an asterisk. Black trans lives matter.
I am not a threat. I'm a father.
Ah, craziness!
I'm a husband. I'm a son. I'm a brother. I'm a friend. I'm a neighbor. I'm a dreamer. I'm a human. A human.
Breonna Taylor, say her name, 26 years old, gone. Because the Louisville Metro Police Department failed to do their job. She was shot 8 times in her home because of a no-knock. Are you kidding me? 8 times. And to know that the person that they was looking for was already in police custody. So they barged in her home. Did not ask questions, did not identify themselves, shot this beautiful soul 8 times. 8 times. Her boyfriend shot back. He's thinking it's intruders. By the grace of God, he's still here, but this beautiful soul is gone. Her life mattered. She deserved justice. She worked for the EMT of Louisville, Kentucky. Black Lives Matter. Say her name. Breonna Taylor. Say her name.
Girls always come up to me and they're like, oh my gosh, like I've been trying to get my hair that curly too. Like, what do you use? Like, what do? Tell me. Water! Because I'm black!
When people say, just brush your naturally curly hair, just brush it.
Okay, sis, now what? Like, what's next, Tiffany, huh? What do I do now?
I really need y'all to listen to this whole thing, especially if you're black.
Okay, so the Bully Lunch Letter was a short speech written by a slave owner to other slave owners. He said, I quote, I have a foolproof method for controlling black slaves. I guarantee every one of you that if done correctly, it will control them and turn them against each other for the next 300 years at least. In the speech, he instructed a lot of different tactics, but one stood out to me the most because it's very relevant today. So he instructed that light-skinned get to work in the house, they got occasional freedom, some got an education, and they had overall better treatment. Dark-skinned had to work in the field. He hoped that this would separate us in the sense of skin complexion, and I think he did a pretty darn good job. Have you ever heard or said the phrase, I only like light-skinned with curly hair? Where do you think that the hate for darker skin and coarse hair in the black community comes from? They literally achieved their goal of brainwashing us. We need to free ourselves from mental slavery ASAP.
Between teeth, now bring my boys in. Their skin in craters like the moon. The moon we love like a brother. While he glows through the room.
Dancing around the lies we tell. Dancing around big eyes is all out.
Even the comatose, they don't dance and tell.
We live in cities. You'll never on screen, not very pretty, but we sure know how to run.
Don't scroll and please share a copy link this because I'm going to be using the word lynching
about 20 times in the next minute because lynching is not officially federally illegal in the United States. If you don't believe me, here's the proof. And before you say lynching is no longer an issue in the United States, the United Nations refers to the murders of George Floyd, Breonna Taylor, and Ahmaud Arbery as lynching. Okay, so it looks like lynching happened in all the United States except for four of them. 200 anti-lynching bills have been introduced to Congress, and that the Senate has considered but failed to enact anti-lynching legislation despite repeated requests by civil rights groups, presidents, and the House of Representatives to do so. Congress is saying this, that you can still do something about it. You can call your senator. You can sign one of the petitions that I'm going to be leaving in the description. Please, please sign them. Please call. Thank you, and have a great night. I got you good. That's it.